User Guide Guide. Welcome, everybody. This is the User Guide Guide. Not quite sure what to entitle this. Right, now, you're intelligent people. This is about the 12.4-metre telescopic 40-foot, seven elements, giving you eight, nine bands. I've forgotten, I've lost count. The whole of HF. So, first of all, let's just go and find the user guide. So all you need to do is do a search for DX Commander user guide. I mean, that can't be, well, user spelt wrong. Google knows where it is, okay? And here we are. And I haven't prettied this up for a while. We're hopefully swapping to our new website soon. But anyway, you can see it says 12.4. I'll put it right in the middle of the screen. There it is there. 12.4 signature user guide. So we'll open that up and here it is. I am not going through the whole thing. I'm going to cover with you the three things that I think you need to know. Because if you've got the confidence to build this, and you should have, anybody can. I mean, Evie, who's 10, built a classic, all right? With the help from her dad, but she did all the work, right? So you can do it as well, unless you're 9, right? Who knows? So what's the first thing we need to do? I'll just run through, as I'm chatting, right? I'll just let you see some pictures and a little bit of B-roll as I'm chatting away. So the seven elements it does, 80 and 30 on one element. So we're going to cover a coil in a minute, all right? We're going to cover the idea of a hinge for you in a minute. And then there was one other thing, and I've totally forgotten what it is. So we'll come to that in a minute. What the hell was that? Oh, yes. We're going to cover the actual pole itself. Okay. So the pole has a screw cap. You take that cap off and you put on the ground plate, the one with the tab. It is all in the user guide, right? Everything on this kit I've intentionally made quite a tight fit. Okay. So on the driven plate, that's the one that has all the elements going up. If you look on the inside diameter of the hole, I've just noticed, and I've already shipped a load, so I can't fix, there's a tiny pip where the water jet machine just missed. You might want to just file that off, bit of sandpaper, doesn't matter. It is still a tight fit. I've done that intentionally. Okay, so that's just covered that. The pole, the first, it's a 12-section pole. The first 9 sections should pull out, on average, between 95 centimetres and 102. And I can't remember how many inches that is. About 40 inches. There we are. And when it's completely, the top 3 sections, by the way, we averaged about 104, 105, 106 centimetres. So that's going to be about 42-ish inches. But I'm only saying that in case you measure and go, oh, this one's only 30. Inches. That means there's 10 inches still embedded in there. All right. So get your partner and your friend or whatever and just give it a tug. If it pulls so far out that you can start to see where there's no paint, you've gone a wee bit too far. Just go in a bit. We'll seal all these joins up anyway. Put a massive clamp on so it doesn't matter. The third join down. Oh, what number is that? Number 2, number 3 doesn't have a hose clamp. Instead, I want you to do 7, 8, 9 turns of Temflex tape that we give you. I want you to Temflex it all, but the 3M Temflex insulation tape, go around that join and just above it, nice, you know, fatten it out. We supply 2 zip ties. They're releasable zip ties. You can use any zip tie. I've tested these and I like them. Put it on and get your pliers and twist it back to get the final click out of that zip tie. Only the one at the top, when you run out. We supply 9 hose clamps, the last one. The next day or the day after when you think, oh, it's all done now, just remember to go back and see if you can get one more click out of that. That's all. So that's the pole. I'll cover the 80 meter element because that's the most complicated. The rest of them are a breeze. Before I do that, I just want to do the hinge. Now, I took some, it's the second time I've made this video. We took some footage and with this, actually, and we got a nice gimbal for it and everything else. The audio failed. I've rebooted the phone now and it's all working in. But anyway, You can make a pseudo hinge. Get yourself a short piece of broom handle or a bit of aluminium. Doesn't have to be the right diameter or anything. But take the rubber bung out the screw cap, put it up the base with a bit of paracord at the bottom, and guide that to one or two guide stakes. All this is in the manual, okay? Really close. I'm talking 158 inches, give or take, 6 inches, away from the base, a couple of guide stakes on that tube. Then when you lift the whole thing up, the base won't move. That's all. It might lift up a bit, but it will soon come down when the center of gravity changes. Pseudo hinge. I've tried it. It works. 80 meters. So 80 meters at, it says it in here, 80, so on page 11, we've got, I don't know, cut slightly longer than you need. 20, I think I said 22 and a half meters. It's all in the manual. Measure from the bottom to 7.78 meters. Buy yourself a dual tape measure. The whole of the world's got centimeters and normally inches on the back, apart from you guys in the USA, it's just all inches. Get one with centimeters as well, right? It's kind of a little bit more accurate and easier in science terms to use these terms. 7.78, 20 something feet. Get your Temflex and just mark 7.78, right? So slow right down and I'll show some pictures. Okay, here is a picture at the bottom of the coil coming up. So down from the right hand side of this picture, 7.78 meters away, it comes up. You need to stop there and make a bit of a loop. Use some of your Temflex tape. By the way, we'll replace all Temflex apart from the ones around the joins of the pole with glue lined heat shrink. We'll do that in a couple of days time, right? We're just getting the thing built up now. Get a piece of shock cord and put it through this little loop you've made and go up. It's about a foot and a half, give or take, to the next, which is about 45 centimeters, up to the next spreader plate. Come up there, leave yourself 30 centimeters, 1 foot, cut it off just so you've got some free here. Now then, about 8 inches, 200 millimeters, less than that, 180 mil, says it in the manual. Do another knot, because the second knot, stopper knot, and by the way, how to make a stopper knot, it's all in the manual, right? Because the two knots, one is going to support the element going down the pole, and the other element is going to the other knot is going to support the element going up the pole. That's all. So we can keep it tensioned. So we have a bit of a gap. We then go around again. Let's find it in the. Here we are. There's a picture on it here on page 12. I've got 99 turns, I think, on this. Maybe 100 or 98. I can't remember. You go around and you can see, actually, I even did this. You can see the one on the right here on the screen. There's a little knot. And then there's this, I call it slack. Because what we don't want is tension getting mixed up with the coil. It just can start to pull the coil apart and everything. And that's the reason for the two knots, okay? So if you look at it, our two loops are inside the two knots. So when everything's tensioned up, I mean, a picture is 1,000 words, isn't it? We've got to make head or tail of this. In my opinion, my picture's slightly wrong. I would say my knot here, right, is about that much too far to the left. Be better off just down a bit, because I can't tension that very hard before I start unwinding that coil. There we are. That's the main thing. The rest of it, just get yourself a cup of coffee or whatever else. Either get it on your iPad or not a phone, because it's a big PDF. It's 17, 18 pages. Or print it off. I printed mine off today. And just go through it with your highlighter pen. Oh, yes, I completely understand that now. I completely understand that. Now, if you get mixed up, we have a Discord server where support is offered to people like you. Go, oh, can't get this to work for whatever reason. You know, how does this bit go in? Discord.io/DX Commander. Okay, you don't need to. They'll say, well, do you want to download the app and everything? You don't need the app. You can just log in with the browser, by the way. And you'll get a password, whatever. Use your email, you know. Use your call sign as well, so we know who you are. Otherwise, we get, you know, people going, you know, Harry Potter, things like that. I mean, we'll answer Harry Potter's inquiry. But it's a lot easier if we know it's, you know, Whiskey 4, Alpha Bravo Charlie, you know. Read the manual. Read the user guide, okay? And we'll all be fine. I'm about to go to Cornwall for a week. I need it. So we've been working flat out. Enjoy your user guide. Enjoy your 12.4. I have genuinely been having a ball with mine. Best antenna I've ever made. All right, so there we are. I think it's about time I shut up now. So all the best, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.